points of that. I want the names. Not the names. The fastest multiverse gets the first three. Anything you want to go?
Mastering fundamentals, learning your style, increasing knowledge, building skills, and demonstrating.
Okay, we have a clear winner for you. I said fastest mods first, then talk about writing here. Okay, moving on. Now, each of these five levels have something called required projects. What are these required projects? These are the projects that are mostly, that are compulsorily, that must be compulsorily taken part with and achieved. And let's start off with talking about the first level. Let's go level by level. So the first level would be mastering fundamentals. Fundamentals, as we know, has been completely revamped. Fundamentals used to be learning, giving the icebreaker, then structuring your speech, body language, vocal variety, and so on. But let me give you another example that if a hunter has to be really good, he needs to know how hunting feels. Then he needs to evaluate himself to come up with a better strategy. And once he gets the feedback stuck in his mind, he will be able to research properly and come up with another better solution and therefore improve his hunting abilities. Similarly, we have the fundamentals revamped into the icebreaker, evaluation and feedback, research and presenting. Icebreaker gives you the feel of how to present a speech, while evaluation and feedback teaches how to give an evaluation as well as take feedback. And using that feedback, we can research well and give the third project, researching and presentation. That covers mastering fundamentals. Let's go to level 2. Believe me guys, level 2 is the most confusing and by far the most important part of pathways. And so, keep your ears sharp. What you see is not a complicated mathematical diagram from set theory, but mostly a clear and organized picture of what level 2 offers to you. Now we have two distinct paths as Toastmasters kept communicating since its inception. We have the communication and the leadership. So we are keeping leadership style and communication style as the base model over here. This circle focuses on the communication style and this blue one focuses on the leadership style. And the ones highlighted in yellow are the paths. Transformation, mastery, motivation, strategies, and so on. Now, the first project of level 2 will be decided by the project you will choose. If you choose a project that completely focuses on communication, and there is only one project that completely focuses on communication, and that would be presentation mastery, then the first project of your level 2 would be understanding your communication style. If you choose one of the projects from this part of the circle, innovative planning, leadership development, and so on, you will be getting understanding your leadership style as your first project. If you have the path somewhere between these two circles, that is effective coaching, dynamic leadership, and visionary communication, then you have both these projects in your level 2. These other projects highlighted in black will be the projects that are mostly unique to the path chosen. So if you have chosen innovative planning, you get a project with, along with understanding your leadership and leadership style, you get connect with your audience. If you choose presentation mastery, you get effective body language and understanding your communication style. There is one more circle, which is the yellow one. And these have all these projects along with another required project called active listening. So what happens basically is each project is quite different from other parts. And so people are generally under the misconception that since level one is similar, the rest of the levels will be the same as well, which is completely wrong. And also, key important thing is that the new path, engaging humor, has a separate domain of it itself. These projects don't apply for engaging humor because it derives inspiration from your advanced communication series, humorously speaking. And so you will have required projects, know your sense of humor and connect your audience. Along with these required projects in level 2, you will also come across something called understanding mentorship. Introduction to mentorship. And this will be introduced in level 2 as I'm talking about it. And it was clearly explained by Toastmaster Dinakar in one of his speeches. When you come across a project called Introduction to Mentorship, you will activate a completely new path free of cost that completely focuses on mentorship. To give you a small intro about that, there will be 4 levels. Introduction to Mentorship has a level 2, Learn to be a Mentor, Become a Mentor, and Advanced Mentoring Projects. Once you are done with these projects and a single path, you will be officially recognized by Toastmasters as a pathways mentor. And that is level 2. Now level 3, what is level 3? What do you call it? Anyone? Agzai Washa. Increasing knowledge. Sorry, level. Increasing knowledge. And so level 3 and level 4 is a bit different. Level 3 is increasing knowledge and level 4 is building skills. Along with a specific required project, you will be told to take an elective path. It can be 1 or 2. Level 3 offers 2 elective. Level 3 requires you to complete 2 elective paths, whereas level 4 requires you to complete 1. This is level 3, 1 required project, and these will be the elective paths. There will be resources, features, characters, students. You can choose any 2 to finish your level 3. Oh, one more thing. Level 3 also requires you to be a Toastmaster, Topic Master, as well as an evaluator to completely fulfill the criteria. And as I said, level 4 also requires a project and 1 elective speech. The speech the project can be to create a podcast, building a social media presence, managing projects, or public leadership strategies. It is required to complete these elective projects. It is very important to complete them the right way. If you are talking about creating a podcast, you have to create a podcast, run it successfully for at least a month or so, and then speak on it. As I mentioned earlier, it is a practical approach. Pathways is a practical approach. And therefore, it requires sometimes it requires you to think about it, come up with an idea, maybe sit back, relax and observe, do certain projects and then speak about it. The good part about this is, if you are not getting a speech slot in Toastmasters, you can still complete these things in the background and still be qualified to, still be eligible to complete these projects. And now we have level 5. Level 5 requires 1 required project, 1 elective project, and also to reflect on your path. Reflect on your path is quite unique. It is basically a culmination of thoughts and what you feel about your entire journey through pathways, and then you have to talk about that in your speech. Now, we also have a not so surprising question. How many core competencies are there?
Five.
What are they? The fastest small first. Okay, we have 2 more. Anyone else?
Public speaking. Effective coaching.
Management.
Interpersonal communication.
That's done.
Confidence.
Yeah.
Leadership. And?
Visionary communication.
That's a path.
Active listening.
Okay, Toastmasters Irene has come up with the most correct answers, and so she will be getting the next week. Do you want 2 or 3? Because Harsha or not getting 2 speeds, so. 3
speeds.
Alright, we'll discuss all these disputes later on. So we have 2 winners over here. There is one more chance of you getting a delicious week. But let's move on. Then we are going to pathways in action. Now, since you know what pathways is, let's do something hands-on so you can understand better. Because most of the people are confused in the doing part rather than the understanding part. So let's go into it. How many of you know this website?
Of course.
That's fantastic. You guys are truly Toastmasters. So first we go to Toastmasters.org to access our paths. Our VP education has already logged in. So first, the first step would be after logging in to go to pathway, select this path and choose a path. We have two options basically. Choose a path and go to base camp. Let's choose a path right now. Okay, when you click on choose a path, you will be refreshed with this page where you have this whole set of options. So you come here, if you are new to pathways, you go here, you continue the path selection. Okay, and so you will come across this. Okay, you are the VP, you get.
Yeah.
Let's go to the backup office.
Who should we select the path for?
Oh, okay,
who hasn't registered?
Oh, let's go to there.
They already
have. No, it's fine.
I can't.
Okay, choose someone. And so you will be redirected to a page where you will be asked to answer a set of questions. Once you answer all these set of questions, you will be redirected to a page which gives you three top selections based on the inputs you have given. Okay, and can we go to the back? Once you take yes, this is how the assessment is going to look like. Once you do all the assessment, you will be given basically three options. You can choose your parts among the three parts, or you can also choose something which is not related to that and still proceed. Once you have chosen the path, you basically go back to the home section where you have this option called go to base camp. Once you click on go to base camp, you will be redirected to this path. This is where all your projects are stored. You have pursued this person, basically me, is pursuing influence, strategic relationship, and these are going to be the demos. So can we go over the curriculum? Okay, yeah. So when you go into a path, you will have these different levels over here where you can switch to different levels. And first you have to complete the icebreaker, right? So you click on launch over here. When you click on launch, this is going to appear. This is basically why, because your pop-up blocker has been enabled. We have to disable it. Or you can click here for the time. Once you click that and you bypass the pop-up blocker, you will be taken to the front page of that specific project, the navigation, which basically describes how to navigate through the entire project. Then you click forward, you basically are introduced to the introduction. This is the introduction of an icebreaker speech. So it talks about different stuff like beginning, culmination, and your corpus overview. You will also come across a page something similar to it, your assignment, where if you click on this link for project checklist,